Quantum computing represents a groundbreaking approach to computing that operates on the principles of quantum mechanics. Unlike classical computers, which use binary digits or bits to encode information as either a 0 or 1, quantum computers utilized qubits that can exist in multiple states simultaneously, known as a superposition of states. We will get into it in a moment. But this characteristic of qubits enables quantum computers to perform specific computations much faster than classical computers, making them well-suited for tackling some of the most complex challenges in fields, such as cryptography, finance, and scientific research. With the potential to revolutionize the way we process information, quantum computing represents an exciting and rapidly evolving field with far-reaching implications for technology and society as a whole. As we delve further into the realm of quantum computing, we encounter one of its fundamental principles, and that is superposition, which is rooted in the theories of quantum mechanics. Superposition enables the creation of quantum bits or qubits that can simultaneously represent both a 0 and a 1. Thus, a single qubit can exist in two states at once, which is a concept that defies traditional binary computing. When we add more qubits, the number of possible states increases exponentially, so that with 2 qubits, we can represent 4 states, with 3 we can represent 8 and so on. This unprecedented growth in computing power is what makes quantum computing a promising field with the potential to revolutionize the world of computing as we know it. The next most significant and intriguing principle is entanglement. It refers to a state where 2 or more qubits, the basic unit of quantum information, become intertwined in a manner that cannot be accounted for by classical physics. The phenomenon of entanglement enables quantum computers to perform computations with an unparalleled speed that classical computers cannot match. The interconnectedness of entangled qubits allows them to instantaneously share information, regardless of the distance between them, and to perform certain operations in a parallel manner, leading to exponential speedup in some algorithms. The behavior of entangled qubits defies our classical intuition, leading to a rich and exciting area of research that holds the promise of revolutionary advancements in fields such as cryptography, machine learning, and material sciences. The third principle is known as interference. In quantum mechanics, interference refers to the interaction of 2 or more quantum systems, such as qubits, which results in the modification of their individual states. The way in which these states are modified depends on their relative phase, which can either reinforce or cancel out their effects. In the context of quantum computing, interference plays a crucial role in enabling certain calculations that are difficult or impossible for classical computers to perform. This is because quantum computers rely on the principles of superposition and entanglement, which allow them to manipulate qubits in ways that are not possible with classical bits. And the last one is called measurements. Measurement is a crucial part of quantum computing, as it is the only way to extract information from a qubit. However, measurement in quantum mechanics is different from measurement in classical physics, and it can be a bit difficult to understand. In classical physics, when we measure a property of an object, we get a definite value. For example, if we measure the position of a particle, we get a specific location. In quantum mechanics, however, when we measure a property of a qubit, we don't always get a definite value. Instead, we get a probability of obtaining a certain value. It's important to note that measurement destroys the superposition of the qubit. Once a qubit is measured, it collapses into a definite state, and we lose all the information about the other possible states it was in. This makes it challenging to perform certain quantum algorithms, which rely on maintaining the superposition of multiple qubits until the final measurement. These principles are fundamental to quantum mechanics and are what makes quantum computing so different from classical computing. They allow quantum computers to perform certain calculations much faster than classical computers, but also pose challenges for building and operating quantum computers. Quantum computing is a revolutionary technology that has the potential to solve problems beyond the capabilities of classical computing. However, it also poses several challenges that must be addressed before it can be fully realized. Among these challenges, one of the most significant is the issue of error correction. Quantum bits, or qubits, are the fundamental building blocks of quantum computing. While classical bits can only be in a state of 0 or 1, qubits can exist simultaneously in various states, which allows for exponentially faster computing. However, this also makes qubits incredibly fragile and prone to errors from external factors, such as temperature fluctuations or electromagnetic radiation. Even the slightest disturbance can cause a qubit to lose its quantum state, leading to errors in calculations. As quantum computers require millions of qubits to perform complex tasks, the likelihood of errors becomes even higher. Therefore, sophisticated error correction algorithms are necessary to ensure accurate results. Developing effective error correction methods is a significant challenge in the field of quantum computing. It requires researchers to find ways to detect and correct errors without destroying the delicate quantum state of the qubits. Many approaches are currently being explored, including the use of redundant qubits and error-detecting codes. Despite these challenges, the potential benefits of quantum computing are enormous. It could lead to breakthroughs in areas such as drug discovery, cryptography, and optimization problems that are currently intractable with classical computers. Therefore, the effort to overcome the challenge of error correction is vital to realizing the full potential of quantum computing. Quantum computers have demonstrated exceptional prowess in tackling complex mathematical problems, such as factoring large numbers. This specific capability of quantum computing is of immense significance, as modern encryption techniques depend on the computational intractability of such operations for classical computers. The ability of quantum computers to break such encryption methods at an accelerated pace compared to classical computers could have far-reaching implications for cybersecurity. Hence, it is imperative to continue research in this field and find ways to safeguard against the potential threats posed by quantum computing. Simulating the behavior of molecules is a complex task with numerous variables involved, making it a significant challenge for classical computers. However, with the advent of quantum computers, there is the potential for more accurate simulations that could have practical applications in drug development and material science. These simulations involve understanding the interactions of individual atoms and molecules, and predicting their behavior in different environments. By leveraging the principles of quantum mechanics, quantum computers can manipulate and analyze quantum states to generate more precise simulations. This has the potential to accelerate the discovery of new materials and drugs, as well as aid in the optimization of existing ones, ultimately benefiting industries and mankind. Now, since advantages can be appealing, the disadvantages of quantum computing should not be ignored. It is equally important to address the demerits and concerns surrounding quantum computing. Some people worry that quantum computers could be used to break encryption methods and compromise sensitive data. While this is a valid concern, it's important to note that quantum computers are not a magic bullet for cracking encryption. The algorithms used in many encryption methods can be updated to be resistant to quantum attacks. Another concern is that quantum computers could be used to simulate the behavior of complex molecules, which could have both positive and negative consequences. On one hand, this could be used to develop new drugs and materials more quickly and efficiently. On the other hand, it could also be used to develop new weapons or other harmful substances. It's important for researchers, policymakers, and the public to carefully consider the ethical implications of quantum computing and work to ensure that it is used for the greater good. You see, building a quantum computer from scratch can be expensive, time-consuming, and technically complex, which can limit the accessibility of this technology to researchers and developers who lack the necessary resources. To address this challenge, companies like IBM and Google have made quantum computers available through cloud services. In other words, they have created virtual access to their quantum computing hardware, allowing users to perform quantum computations without needing to build and maintain their own machines. This approach has opened up the field of quantum computing to a broader audience, enabling researchers, developers, and businesses to experiment with quantum algorithms and applications without significant upfront investment. Now, if you didn't know how it operates, let me give you an idea. Cloud-based quantum computing services work by providing users with a web-based interface that enables them to design and run quantum algorithms on the company's quantum computing hardware. The interface typically includes a user-friendly programming environment that allows users to write quantum code in a familiar programming language, such as Python or Qiskit. Users can then submit their code to the company's quantum computing hardware, which performs the quantum computations and returns the results to the user. Moreover, cloud-based quantum computing services can provide scalability and flexibility to businesses that need to perform computationally intensive tasks. For instance, companies can use quantum computing to optimize complex supply chains, simulate chemical reactions, or improve financial modeling. By leveraging cloud-based quantum computing services, businesses can access the necessary computing power on demand without needing to invest in expensive hardware that may not be fully utilized. While we may not see widespread adoption of quantum computers for a few more years, the potential impact on our world is truly staggering. With that, we hope this video has given you a better understanding of what quantum computing is and what it could mean for our future. If you found this video helpful, please like, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more informative content. Thank you for watching, and before you leave, check this video out.